Structural Studies of Phycobiliproteins from Spirulina. Spirulina is considered to be an excellent source of proteins. The structural composition of spirulina includes phycobiliproteins that contain a covalently attached chromophore called phycocyanobilin, which is in a planar conformation when the protein is in native form. When the protein is denatured, this chromophore undergoes a conformational change, leading to a change in the absorption spectrum, which is recorded at 625 nanometer using a UV spectrophotometer. This experiment examines the structural changes occurring in phycobiliproteins upon denaturation with protein denaturants like urea and potassium thiocyanate employing UV vis spectroscopy. Materials required: weighing balance, spirulina tablets, watch glass, spatula, 100 ml beaker, sonication chamber, ammonium sulfate powder, magnetic stirrer. Procedure: arrange the required materials on the lab bench. Preparation of phycobiliproteins from spirulina. Place the weighing dish over the weighing balance and tear the balance to zero. Take four spirulina tablets, open them and empty the contents into a watch glass. Using a spatula, transfer the spirulina powder from the watch glass to the watch glass, kept over the weighing balance, and note the weight, which should be approximately 2 grams. Transfer the powder into a 100 ml beaker with a spatula. Using a 100 ml measuring jar, measure 50 ml of 0.1 molar potassium phosphate buffer at pH 7. Pour this into the beaker containing the spirulina powder. Mix the solution using a glass rod. The color of the solution changes to deep blue color. The spirulina solution is then sonicated to break the cells and release the proteins. Sonication is done 5 to 6 times for 1 minute at intervals of 5 minutes. The solution is then centrifuged to remove the cell debris. For this, the solution is transferred into the centrifuge tubes. Centrifugation is done for 20 minutes at 24,000 rpm at 4 degrees Celsius. After 20 minutes, take out the tubes from the centrifuge and you will notice blue pellets in each tube. The supernatant is transferred into 250 ml beaker. Take 50 ml of 0.1 molar potassium phosphate buffer at pH 7 in a measuring jar. Make the volume of spirulina solution to 100 ml by adding 0.1 molar potassium phosphate buffer at pH 7 from the measuring jar. Weigh 29 g of ammonium sulfate powder and add it to the spirulina solution. Mix the solution using a magnetic stirrer for 5 minutes. After stirring, the solution is again centrifuged to isolate the proteins. Centrifugation is done for 10 minutes at 16,000 rpm at 4 degrees Celsius. The supernatant is transferred into a 250 ml beaker and discarded, whereas the pellets remain in each tube. Measure 25 ml buffer in a measuring jar and add it to the pellet in each tube. Dissolve the pellet in the added buffer by shaking the contents in the tubes with the hand. Transfer the solution into a conical flask. Protein denaturation studies. Transfer 3 ml of potassium phosphate buffer into a cuvette using a pipette to be used as a blank. To a second cuvette, add 3 ml of potassium phosphate buffer using a pipette. Add 100 microliter protein solution into this cuvette and mix it well using the pipette. Then place the cuvettes in the UV spectrometer slots and record the spectrum at 625 nanometer. The solution is discarded and the cuvette is washed and dried. Now 1.5 ml potassium phosphate buffer is taken in the cuvette. Then add the denaturant of 1.5 ml 8 molar potassium thiocyanate to the cuvette. And finally add 100 microliter protein solution and mix well using a pipette. Then place the cuvettes in the UV spectrometer slots and record the spectrum at 625 nanometer. The solution is then discarded and the cuvette is washed well and dried. Take 2.25 ml of potassium phosphate buffer in a cuvette. Then add 750 microliter of the second denaturant, 8 molar urea to the cuvette. Finally, transfer 100 microliter of protein solution to this cuvette. Mix well using a pipette. Place the cuvettes in the UV spectrometer slots and record the spectrum at 625 nanometer. After the measurements are completed, both equids are removed from the UV spectrometer.